I'm Aaron Plessinger, and I choose OGO.
I'm Levi Kitchen, and I choose OGO.
I'm Malcolm Stewart, and I choose OGO.
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 Rough, bad, all the negative words, unfortunately. So, like I was just telling you before you started rolling, just had crash in qualifying two. Jammed my knee up and heat race had a little bobble and dabbed the same leg, jammed it again. So a toroidal shot didn't really help me after all. It felt really great until then, but you know, when I get a double whammy on one knee, it kind of just all went down the drain per se. So overall a rough day, but you know, it's the I can kind of say that not all of it was on me. You know, normally I'd take the blame, but you know, the crash was definitely on me, and you know, other stuff happened though that was out of my control, getting into it with other guys. So, yeah, a rough result, but overall I can take positives away from this and throw the negatives away, and you know, take some of the negatives and work on it and show up next weekend.
Okay, now that you have a toroidal shot, I mean, you've at least been checked out a little bit. There's a wrap on your knee. Do you know, like, if it's damaged pretty bad or is it just hurting really bad?
I wish I could tell you what the muscle is called. I would need to call Dr. Nick in to give you the scientific answer, but basically there's a muscle in there that it's on the back side of your knee, so it's not my ACL or anything like that, but it's a muscle that basically the way it was explained to me was kind of holds in place like your PCL, and if it's popping, then that's a good thing, as bad as it sounds. You know, that means there's still, if it was torn, I guess it wouldn't pop. So whatever the muscle is, it's good to go. It's basically just pulled it and strained it, and I'll be good to go for next weekend. So
I was pretty good. Struggled a lot in qualifying this morning, and just struggled getting used to the track, but picked it back up. Heat race was good, and got another good start in the main, and got the track figured out a little bit better. Struggled in the mid part of the race, and then picked it back up the last couple laps. Got a good flow going, so I'm definitely not satisfied yet. Gonna come out swinging and do some work before St. Louis.
Yeah, I definitely noticed the ebb and flow. Strong early in the main event, a little bit of a plateau there in the middle, and then strong again at the end.
Yeah, for sure. I don't know. I don't know what happened in the middle. I had a good flow going in the beginning, and then middle, I just lost that flow for a couple laps, made some mistakes, and then I got the flow going again later on in the main event. So need to fix some things, but it'll be better.
Okay, I have to like go further on that. Sometimes when I ride and I have like three laps, I'm like, all right, well, I'm just practicing so I can pull off. You don't have that option. So how do you reset in the middle of the moto? Like, are you just trying to put one or two clean laps together then? Or are you just trying to put it together section by section to recapture the flow? Like, how do you go about that?
Yeah, I think for sure we worked a lot on being calm at the practice track this last couple weeks. And I think I got a little bit sporadic in the middle of the main. And I started making too many mistakes. I started pushing the track a little bit too much for what it could handle. And Austin put on the pit board, just calm down. And so I started calming down and just trying to ride like myself, flow a little bit more, less brakes, just try to let the track come to me. So I think that was a big part in getting my flow back at the end of that main event.
It was pretty gnarly. Track was borderline survival, but you had to really, really race hard and focus to kind of stay in the hunt. I felt good, like I was riding good all day, but it was my like worst qualifying of the season. I was like 13th overall, but I knew I was riding good. It was kind of weird. The B practice, since it was muddy, was the first top five guys were faster than a lot of the A practice guys. So I was like, try not to overthink it. And then I got off to a decent start in the heat and passed some guys, was in third. And then like two laps to go, I kind of puckered up on a triple, cased it, and I was like, okay, track's gnarly, I just need to get in the main and with a decent gate pick. And Marshfinks put some pressure on me, and I didn't make it too tough on him. I kind of just left the door open and was like, take it, buddy, you're riding good. And followed Marshfinks in on the heat for a fourth. Then main event, I opted to not do the sight lap. I was the only guy to do that, trying to keep my tire fresh. And maybe it was a little too fresh because I wheelied off the start. So it was literally, I think Tony told me I was like 16th on lap one. And I've been training really, really hard. And the team's been working hard. So I knew I had it in me. And I knew that I'm a fighter. And I found some good lines. I stuck to them. And then, you know, next thing you know, I was catching this guy. I was catching the next guy. I was catching the next guy. At one point, I think with like 6 minutes left, I was like ninth. And I seen a few guys were fading in front of me, put some good passes, and got some good factory guys, and ended up fifth. So good ride, strong ride. I feel like I earned that, and I deserved that fifth. So I'm happy with that.
God, I mean, honestly, the track was like probably the hardest supercross I ever rode. On the heat race, I was really close to win, but I just kept dragging my peg. I went to do that triple, went through gas. I just felt like the bike got sucked down when the foot peg hit the rut and cased it, crashed. So that was fortunate. And the main event, right after the over the start, going on the left corner, they had a deep rut. My right side of the peg got caught, threw me off to the right, crashed again, but still got to the podium. So I think the effort was there, kind of just muscled through everything, but making improvements. So I'm happy with it.
That was sick. Yeah, it was perfect from qualifying till the heat race and the main. Went about as good as it could have, I guess I should have said.
I mean, that just had to be a wild weekend, start to finish.
Oh, the wild weekend?
I mean, just like all of it. I mean,
yeah.
Dude, look at this. Like, this is
yeah,
nuts.
It was overwhelming for sure. So I'm glad I did good, or else I would have probably like got mad at myself that I was not focused enough or something weird. So I'm glad. You know, I almost wonder if because all the people, I was like distracted and kind of just went out there and did what I know how to do. So yeah, it was awesome.
All right. Getting into just the nitty gritty of the race and everything, doing the laps. How was it to just do it? Just doing the laps in the main event, 15 minutes. I mean, that's a brutal track.
It was wild. The big thing I knew is when I got out front, like I needed to execute like the first five laps good. Once I did that, I got the gap to like 6 seconds, and then I was pretty much ready to manage it, even if it was that amount of time. And then I heard Smitty panic rev, and I realized he was down, and then I couldn't find anybody. So I was like, I didn't know how big my gap was, but I knew I had room, so I just managed it from there. And even though it might have looked easy on TV, once I got to lappers and stuff, I had some close calls that were, I was just getting so frustrated in my helmet, and I'd have to like get it back together. So it was pretty chaotic.
It was good. The track was tough. It broke down obviously a lot. It gets down to that really hard base here. It's got like all those marbles and rocks. There's just so many rocks in this dirt. But yeah, man, it felt good to get in there out of the heat. I felt so good in my heat race, even in practice. Like, I felt like I was shredding. I think I was like sixth early, and everyone was like, "Oh, dude, that's sick." And it qualified like 15th, and then right out of my heat into the main. Should have been even better in my heat race. I started way back in it, like always. That's the main problem. But the main, I got clobbered by Master Pool on the first lap. He like cut across the landing of a double, and I like T-boned him in the air. So I started way back, and I was catching up, and right when I got to like the back of the pack, I started getting lapped. And I think we all kind of know my reputation. So I was, again, practicing racing while staying out of their way, which I think I did a very good job of this week. And this track felt like it was easy to get out of the way. It felt wide to me, like really wide. So I don't know if like last weekend just felt narrow because it was all those tight corners where we were going inside and whatnot. But like this track felt like it was easy to like be fast and stay out of their way.
All right. I mean, it looked brutal out there. I mean, there's no secret that was a tough day weather-wise and all that. And everything, and walking it was nuts. You know, just from lap to lap, though, watching how the lines were going, did you deviate around a lot, or were you just stuck to one?
I deviated on maybe the once on like the finish line side of the track. I moved around a lot. On the other side of the track, I kind of stayed in the same line. I tried a few different lines, but over there, but they weren't really working. That middle rhythm was just so spongy. I actually only jumped it like 3 or 4 times in the main, and then I just committed to like trying to double through it really fast because I could double through it safely the whole main. Trying to throw 2 triples in there, because you had to triple twice or it wasn't faster. So, and if you miss one, it's like a waste of time. So over there, it was more or less just double program all day. But the other side, man, like the on off before the double, was, dude, there were huge rocks on that tabletop and in the face of it. And then the sand, like I was able to jump the wall, I don't know, 3 or 4 times in the main. But yeah, over there, it was just like kind of survival through the sand and then do the wall and then you could start going fast again. But like when I could jump the wall, it felt like the whole track got easier. But then the line went away from me. So I think somebody saw somebody doing it and they just sat there and did a burnout on the lip we were using.
Okay, the last thing, walking off the track, seeing that turn that you guys had before the finish line, and it's down to the plywood. So I have a lot of questions about this. Overall, just how was it? Because like the entry to the turn, you guys are on the plywood, so you're braking on plywood.
Yeah, yeah.
But then it's just as gnarly to get on the gas, and there's the bigger bear spot. But initiating at an angle, front brake, rear brake,
correct.
You know, that's gnarly.
Yeah, you're talking the corner after the finish, right?
After the finish, before the mechanics area.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It was crazy, like all day in the braking zone, we were hitting plywood there, which I've never seen before. And it's just like, it wasn't that bad because you were in the rut. So like you hit the brake and even if your front wheel like spunks a little bit, you hit the wall. So, but you almost pick up speed when you touch the brake and like it loses. So like you have to just be like, okay, I'm sliding. You have to let off and then just send the rut. And the rut is like so strong there. Like even if you...
I mean, Cade, it literally had bricks in it, so...
Oh, dude, it was broody. Like just... But what I'm saying is like... the bank of the rut is so strong, like you could just commit and use the bank of it and almost stay off the plywood in the bottom. But yeah, I mean, there was there the first turn, like it was just plywood, which was awkward. But we've been really fortunate the last like year where we haven't been getting down to that. And I think just the rush build here and stuff like that, they just didn't have enough time to get enough dirt on it. But you know, it is what it is, right?
It was pretty tough. I'm pretty happy with the progress. I'm pretty happy with my effort. My starts were a lot better tonight. My starts were consistent. And so it's I'm trying to just keep the pressure on, keep putting myself in that position and keep learning. Tonight, the track was actually really rough as well as rutted. So my bike honestly beat me up pretty good. And that was something that we're gonna fix this week. We've already talked about it, and we have a good plan. It just the track was probably the roughest as far as bumps in the ruts, the roughest track we've had all year. So that was kind of new for me, but the direction that we're trending in, my riding is getting a lot better. Each time during the week is my best day. So yeah, I mean, I don't know what round this is, 10 or 11 or something, 11. But I physically feel really good. I'm mentally, I still want it, and I'm just excited. I'm excited to get back to work. We got one more weekend, and then we get a weekend off, and yeah, it's. I feel like I'm just now really picking up speed, and I'm excited. I mean, I don't want it to end.
Hey, these last few weeks I've been watching, like paying super close attention.
Yep.
You've been battling, and like you've been battling really good guys and everything like that. So everything that you said about the progression that you've made, I've seen it. I've seen the intensity on the track. The results are showing it. It's been good.
Yeah. Well, thanks for noticing. Yeah. Oh, no. I'm glad somebody did.
The AC battle that you guys were having the last couple weeks, I'm like on the edge of my seat. Yeah. Like, oh my God.
Dude, and I wanted to pass him so bad tonight. He passed me early, and then I passed him.
You guys had it again tonight. Bro, these have been the best battles.
Yeah.
Like, they've been all time.
Yeah. Yeah, it's and the thing is, tonight it was like I was good. I felt like I was catching him a little bit, and I messed up in the rhythm and really came up short. And dude, it took all my strength to like save it, and then I missed the next rhythm, and Oldenburg passed me back, and I'm like, no. And then I was just kind of surviving after that. But honestly, like it's been a lot of fun, and I feel like I'm actually out there racing now, and I'm trying to claw my way up. And so it's there's a lot of respect out there, and I appreciate it. It's keeping me accountable, and I hope that I'm doing the same to those guys.
It was brutal all day. Was really pumped on my heat race. I ripped a good start. I was second for a lap or two, and just did the best I could. I ended up sixth in that, and felt like I learned a lot, and learned the pace a little bit more. So it's kind of what my goal and my plan is, racing the 450. So main event, not a great start. Fought hard, and just I pumped up, and I don't get arm pump. Like I get arm pump. I've had arm pump maybe five or six times in my life, and I hadn't had it tonight. So just really struggled with the position of my clutch lever today. Felt like I was reaching for it a lot in the main event, and I think that's why I pumped up. So we'll go back and get that right, and we go to a covered stadium next weekend. So excited about that. St. Louis, got my last podium there. Good vibes going there. Excited to get some riding in this week, and just continue to build off of that. It was a fun night, and just stoked to survive it.
All right, hey, making it out of the heat race directly, probably a huge help, huh?
Yeah, it's definitely a lot more stressful making it out of the heat in the 450 class. Obviously, you never want to go to an LCQ, but almost in the 250 class, it was almost just like, I'm racing to win the 250 heat races, and getting top nine is never really a question in the 250 class. So just knew if I started up front, I could finish around 4, 5, 6, and that's what I did. So started up front. Definitely huge relief after the heat races when you get directly in, just because anything can happen. So especially on a track like tonight. So a lot more emphasis on the heat races in this class for sure.
Thought I was hurt. Kind of crazy. I went to the medic rig last weekend because I crashed first lap of the first main, said I had a broken collarbone, so then I went to California to get it fixed if it needed to be, and turns out it was not broken. I got like a joint strain right here, right by my collarbone. It felt like a broken collarbone, like it hurt, it still hurts, but we're here racing, so that's all that matters.
Okay, so then at what point today did you know like, oh yeah, we can do it, and then you get it in the main?
Honestly, I felt pretty good all day. I crashed like three laps into the second qualifier and beat my bike up pretty good. Gave my mechanic a lot of work, but I started the heat race really good. I felt pretty good. I rode a little tight towards the end of the heat race, but overall, like, the bike worked really good. I was really happy with how I felt. And then the main started dead last. Struggled getting my whole shot device unlocked, finally got it unlocked, and from there I felt like I had a really good flow on the track. Like I actually raced the whole main event, where I've kind of struggled with that, especially this year. But I couldn't be happier with how I rode. I feel like that was the best main event, like all around main event, that I've raced in a couple years. So overall, very, very happy.
Okay, I'm not like being sarcastic. There's like no like negativity towards this. Can you tell that bike in conditions like that? Like, can you actually tell, like, oh, dude, this thing does it different than other bikes do it?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of wild because the last, like, six races have been really gnarly like this. Just rutted like crazy. And my bike just keeps getting better and better and better. We're making little tweaks on suspension pretty much every time I touch the track. And it is really starting to work good, which is exciting for me, obviously. We struggled in the beginning of the season, but we had kind of expected that. But man, I'm stoked with how it felt today. The suspension was working awesome. Shout out to Bryce, my guy. Hopefully we have a good weekend next week too.
All right. Last thing, kind of going back to that second practice crash. Mm-hmm. Is it nice to know, like, hey, I can take a slam, get up, know I'm okay after the week that you probably had?
Yeah, definitely. As soon as I started taking off, I knew I was going to crash, and I was perfectly fine. I pulled it in the mechanics area, and my mechanic's like, what do we need to fix? I'm like, I don't think you understand. Like, I don't know how I messed the bike up that bad, but it was like, I bent a lot of stuff, and I just told him, I'm like, it's too bent or I'm not going to be able to go faster. So we went back, rested, did a little therapy on my injury, and yeah.
I think Seattle, I mean, honestly, for the way the track could have turned out, it was, with the rain, and it actually was actually a lot better than I thought. So the track did get pretty gnarly. I think we were at heat race, we were like P4, so felt pretty good there, and then went to the main event and just struggled just to get a groove. I just, this is definitely one of those tracks where the track got really, really tough, ruddy, everything that Seattle was all about. And man, when you're off, you just, you're really, really off. So got on pump pretty quick. I actually got it before I even got halfway, and just kind of tried to survive. But you know, it's one of those things, one of those days that just happens to just happen for you like that. But, we're going to be all right. I think the team, we're all wrapped our head around what we're going to try to do and try to come up with something a little bit better leading to the weekend. So for St. Louis. So it's another triple crown. So I think it should be pretty good.
It was good. One of the better weekends I've had in a couple weeks. And yeah, I wish I had a better start because man, I was humming those last six laps of the main. I was coming for it, and I was riding good. I felt good. The bike was working good. I was working good. It was just an all around good race. But you can't really get much done when you start in 12th place. So I got to execute the main starts better. And overall, just rode really good. I was right behind Jett at the finish, and I think I got it down within, 1 second or, a half a second. So I'm pumped on that. I'm pumped on my heat race. It was a really, really good weekend overall, and I'm looking forward to getting back this week and getting back into that flow that I had in the beginning of the season, just kind of clicking off podiums and getting good starts and putting myself in good positions. I think that's the biggest thing is putting myself in better scenarios to not have the situations that I've had happen.
Ups and downs. Good heat race, good qualifying. In the main, had a not the best start, but made my way through to third. Was right on the back of Cooper and just kind of didn't hit that turn a little faster than I thought, and just ended up clipping the back of him. And then a few other little kind of warning shots almost, and this kind of little mistakes that it was like, all right, well, we'll just come home and in third get what we get given. So we got that. Bit bumps, was running really good at the start, but it is what it is.
Okay, you've talked all year about taking what it comes and not pushing it, and today was the test of that because, you could have easily made that a three-man battle for the lead, but was it difficult to just kind of simmer down and know I just need to get points instead of having another one?
It's definitely difficult because as a racer, you don't want to stop. You want to keep on going. But at certain times, you just got to kind of grow up and, all right, this is realistically, this is what I should at least go away with instead of trying to push and risk more and then crashing and end up being hurt or going back further. So it's I think it was in the end of the day, it was the right decision to do.
The tracks last few weeks have been gnarly. To see what you guys are out there doing and then the way you're doing it, it's crazy. When you're sitting there on the gate and dude, I got to stay focused for 22 minutes right now. How do you do it?
Yeah, you got to stay focused. Yeah, like you said, you kind of going in, you got to make sure you stay locked in each lap just because any lap can really catch you off guard or catch you out.
Yeah, I like that last little the psych up you guys do right before the starting gate drops. You can tell that's when you're locked in.
Yeah, you try and get that adrenaline going and try and focus in,